journeyman tailors rode up to an inn and called to the landlord to let them in on the Rhine, on the Rhine. Their pockets were empty, their throats were dry, and each of the tailors did set up a cry for wine, for wine. Sir landlord, we've been round the world, and the things that we've seen make your hair come uncurled on the Rhine, on the Rhine. Now each one of us has a magic trick. We'll show you our magic and bring you good luck for wine, for wine. Come in, said the landlord, and opened his doors. If your magic is good, my cellar is yours on the Rhine, on the Rhine. But if you do lie, as I think be so, I'll plant you head downwards to see how you grow. Stead of wine, stead of wine. The first tailor then took a needle of steel. With a sunbeam he threaded it, neat as an eel, on the Rhine, on the Rhine. He picked up a glass that was cracked in three and sewed it together as neat as could be for wine, for wine. The first one sat down and the second arose, seized a mosquito that flew past his nose on the Rhine, on the Rhine. The poor little beast had a cold in its chest. Before it could sneeze, he had made it a vest for wine, for wine. The third tailor said, "You've seen nothing at all," and he buried the needle point deep in the wall on the Rhine, on the Rhine. He flew back and forth through the needle's eye. If I hadn't seen it, I'd say it was a lie for wine, for wine. Sir tailors, your magic is great. I promised you wine and I'll not make you wait on the Rhine, on the Rhine. He drew off a thimble of wine from a vat. All right, you magicians, get drunk on that. There's your wine, there's your wine. The tailors were angry, the tailors did roar. They nailed the innkeeper's ears to the door on the Rhine, on the Rhine. They mounted their horses and rode away, and the innkeeper's ears hang there to this day. On the Rhine, on the Rhine.